Okay, we'll start with a carrier. And two increments are representing the carrier power. And then we'll modulate it right to the point where the look ahead algorithm protects the DAC from clipping. And you can see the negative peaks are restrained to less than 100%, while the positive peaks are allowed to make excursions beyond 100%. Let's see what happens when predistortion, pure signal, is engaged. And that's what the waveform looks like with pure signal engaged. Notice the positive peaks were not changed in any way. There's pure signal not engaged. And pure signal is engaged. Again, there's no change in the level of the positive peaks. And then there's pure signal off. And then back to the carrier itself. Put the modulation back on. And now let's take a look at the AM carrier level, which right now is set to 100. At 100, it's impossible to drive it to the point where the waveform passes through the baseline, creating the little wavelets. But by reducing that below 100, as we're doing it now, the negative peak limiting effect is reduced and completely controlled. You can dial this up and dial this down. Although why you'd want to have wavelets is a mystery to me, but it's an interesting phenomenon on the scope. And then we'll bring it back up. And pass through a setting of 100. Now we're exceeding 100. And you can see that the negative peak effect is still there, and it's enhanced somewhat, while the positive peaks still are allowed to get all the way up to the point, just below the threshold where the DAC begins to clip. We'll bring it back down to a setting of 100. A couple more clicks. And there we go, setting of 100. With the negative peaks restrained before 100%, and the positive peaks continue up again unrestrained. So that's what it looks like